Good evening, Excellency, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome once again to Cambodia Global Dialogue of Southeast Asia TV. Tonight, we'll be discussing on an economic sector, which is the service sector. It relates to infrastructure, but in the context of a larger context of ASEAN. Cambodia is a member of ASEAN. In 2015, we'll be part of the ASEAN economic community. Investment will be flowing in and out. We be going to other country be going to Cambodia. Tourists will come, tourists will go, but it all boils down to our infrastructure. And that's why today I have the pleasure to have with me a good friend, Emmanuel Munoto, who is the Chief Executive Officer of Cambodia Airport. Emmanuel,
good evening.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you very much.
Emmanuel, on peut se tutoyer. Before we go on to the show, perhaps I'll give you 1 minute to introduce yourself a bit about your personal background. Yes, please.
Thank you. Merci. I'm very pleased to be here this evening. Introducing myself, I'm Emmanuel Menantou, in charge of Cambodia Airport now for a little bit more than 6 months.
Okay.
I've been coming to Cambodia, arriving from China. Mm-hmm. Beijing, actually. Mm-hmm. And I would say that when I decided to move from Beijing to Cambodia, many friends asked me why. Mm. And now I can tell them that I've made the right choice.
All right.
Because even Cambodia is a small country. The welcome you get when you arrive is an exceptional welcome. Mm. And I'm very pleased to be in Cambodia for these 6 months.
Yes.
I've been passing almost more than 10 years in Asia now. Mm-hmm. China, India, Singapore, and okay. I would say that I really much enjoy working in Asia, in Southeast Asia. My background is of course aviation, yes. Aerospace. Mm-hmm. I've been working in several companies, multinationals, working with airports, mm-hmm. working with airlines, mm-hmm. Working with air traffic management.
Yes.
In this region.
Yes.
Now coming back to Cambodia Airport.
Yes. Cambodia Airport, before it's the SCA,
Société
Concessionnaire
des Aéroports
de Cambodge. And when did you make the rebranding?
So actually we celebrate
yes.
15 years anniversary
yes.
of SCA
yes.
last year.
Okay.
And we decided at this occasion to rebrand SCA Cambodia Airport,
yes.
which is much easier for everybody to understand.
Yes.
It by itself gives exactly what is the mission
yes.
of our company.
Yes. Emmanuel, Cambodia Airport, you cover Phnom Penh, Siem Reap and Sihanoukville, so all the 3 major international airports in Cambodia.
Yes, it's correct. We cover the 3 airports, international yes. airports yes. Of Cambodia. Just a little bit of background.
Mm, please, a little bit of history help.
A little bit of history.
Yes.
Actually, our company started long time ago in Cambodia, mm-hmm. even in the 60s in the construction.
Is that right?
And then in 95, mm-hmm. the Royal Government of Cambodia decided to open its airport to international concession.
Yes.
And we won this contract. We
yes.
were one of the bidder for this contract
okay.
and we
okay.
won it as a concession.
Yes.
It started with Pochentong Airport in
yes.
Phnom Penh. Then in 2001, untrusted by our relationship, the government of Cambodia gave us Siem Reap
okay.
as a concession.
Yes.
And then in 2006, Sihanoukville.
Mm. Okay.
So this is how we became
yes.
the partner to the government.
You know, you mentioned you came quite a long time ago in 1995. You must have seen, or at least your company must have seen, a tremendous growth in the tourism or the tourist arrival. What's your impression?
It's true. Just a few numbers. In 95,
yes.
Phnom Penh was welcoming around 500,000 passengers.
Mm-hmm.
In 2011, mm-hmm. we are almost to 2 million, 1.85
four
million.
Time, huh?
Four times.
Yes.
Siem Reap,
yes.
it's the same, 200,000 passengers in 2000,
yes.
almost 2 million this year.
Mm.
So we have seen a a tremendous growth in tourism sector, in business sector, which is actually a great change and a great movement for Cambodia.
And last year, you have your first flight, you know, in Sihanoukville.
It is correct. 2011 is a historical moment for the company because we opened officially the first domestic flight between Sihanoukville and Siem Reap with Cambodia Encore Air, the domestic airline.
Yes.
So it has been a great event at the end of the year that, of course, we welcome positively and favorably.
Well, Emmanuel, you know, I'm very excited of the prospect of Cambodia playing, you know, an active role in the region. As you know, this year, Cambodia chair the ASEAN. We will have a lot of business conference of summit leader from many countries will come to Cambodia. And their first impression is always at the arrival, at the airport. And I think the fact that we now have an international airport at the international standard, you know, it's a big, as a Cambodian, it's a big pride also. How do you see the growth of, you know, future investment in the sector, you know, in the airport expansion? Where do you see your company in the next 5 or 10 years from now?
We are preparing the company for that.
Yes.
You're right. We must be proud.
Yes.
Because this year is the year of ASEAN for Cambodia. And the airport will be the first impression you
get. The gateway
yes. when you arrive.
Yes.
Of course, for this occasion, not only for this occasion, but to prepare the increase of traffic, we prepare ourselves to increase the capacity of our airports. So we have decided with our shareholders to invest a lot for the next 8 to 10 years.
Yes.
And we have decided to invest at least 270 million, around 300 million until 2020 for our three airports. Those investments start this year. Maybe you have seen, or for those who are traveling those days, I've seen some works in Sihanoukville, in Siem Reap, and in Phnom Penh, where we increase the parking for our aircraft.
Yes, yes.
We also decided to increase the size of our terminal in Phnom Penh and in Siem Reap, where we will double the capacity of our terminal. We'll be able to welcome more than 4 million passengers when we finish end of 2014.
2014, and we will have the capacity to absorb 4 million.
Yes.
That's quite impressive for a small country.
Yeah. It is, and of course, it is our duty to make those investments to be perfectly in line with our commitment that we have with the government of Cambodia.
How? Most of us are not in civil aviation or in, we don't know much about aircraft, but Air France is landing in Cambodia now, right?
Yes.
They have a huge plane. What is that?
It's a Boeing 777 or 777,
okay,
which is today the latest airplane from Boeing. Of course, before they start the Boeing 787, it's one of the most reliable and profitable aircraft.
It can put so many, how many passengers?
It can put more than 300 passengers in each flight.
And our runway can accommodate this sort of plane now?
Yes, our runway in Phnom Penh is able to accommodate any type of large aircraft. I would say our Phnom Penh airport is also able to accommodate Airbus A380, which is the biggest aircraft today flying in the world.
Yes. Well, you know, I'm just saying that because, you know, when Cambodia hosts the two summit, you know, head of state be coming and they be coming with huge airplane, right? I wonder where, you know, would we have the space to park all this big, you know, aircraft, you know.
But it is always a headache to accommodate this very important aircraft.
Yes, yes.
And this is why we are extending our parking.
Okay.
We know that at the important summit at the end of the year.
Yes.
We will probably have some Boeing 747.
Yes.
And today we are working on 3 additional parking for this type of aircraft, Boeing 747, or a smaller one, of course, that we will accommodate and park in Phnom Penh.
Wow, it's amazing. Speaking on now in Cambodia, in ASEAN per se, you know, in 2015, the economy will be quite open. We already open, but in a larger ASEAN business community. In the service sector, for sure, we will have a free trade in services. My understanding that now they are negotiating about the open sky, ASEAN open sky. So we're gonna go through a years of a lot of excitement. How do you position, you know, Cambodia Airport here in the context, you know, of in terms of infrastructure? You know, would we be able to attract more investment, you know, through that? How do you position in this whole airline industry?
Open sky policy, as you rightly said, is a long story.
Yes.
To make it short, it has been a debate over the different ASEAN summit for years and years.
Yes.
Now they are planning to accommodate this open sky policy by 2015.
Yes.
And it is a tremendous chance for Cambodia. Mm. Because Cambodia today, and especially Cambodia Angkor Air, is ready to expand.
Yes.
As you probably know, they are opening new routes.
Yes.
Korea, mm-hmm. and maybe in the future other routes to Indonesia, Philippines, mm-hmm. Singapore.
Yeah.
Having an open sky, full open sky policy will help airlines such as Cambodia Angkor Air to develop themselves.
Yes.
So of course, for us, having a strong domestic airline, it is having a strong airport company.
The two is linked.
The two goes together.
They go together. If the physical infrastructure of the airport is not there, there is no way you will enable the expansion of the national carrier in that case.
Exactly. So it is our duty to help the national carrier to develop.
Yes.
To help the national carrier to base their activity in Cambodia. Mm. And to offer the service, to offer the facilities that they can expand from their local base, whatever it is, Phnom Penh, Siem Reap, or Sihanoukville.
All the three international airports are fully certified by ICAO, right?
It is correct. They are the three ICAO certified at the latest. Mm. Level of service, at the latest level of regulation.
Yes.
For us, safety and security is the must.
Yes.
And we cannot allow ourselves not to be at this level of of standard.
Exactly. So you would say that in terms of policy, regulation, you as a major actor in the air service industry, you're happy. You're happy of the level of support that the government is involved, right?
Yes, we are working now for many years with the government, especially with the civil aviation, with the Council of Ministers.
Mm-hmm.
We are very happy of the work that we achieved.
Okay.
We are very happy also to have been participated actively to the development of the civil aviation for Cambodia, for its airport, for its airlines.
Mm.
We have regular meetings, we have regular committees, and of course we welcome all new development, whatever it are, airlines, technology for the air traffic management, and companies who are ready to establish themselves in the country to develop activities such as cargo or any activities at the airport.
Yes. Looking from the human resource side, Cambodia in the future will be very much looked upon as a country where we have a lot of human resource, but you know, the level of expertise is not there yet. In your company, number one, how big is the staff now? And number two, you must have a series of capacity building, technical training to raise up their skill level. Do you have such a program?
Yes, to answer your first question, today we are 1,300 people among the three airports.
Yes.
Almost half-half,
yes.
Phnom Penh and Siem Reap. I would like to say that I've been absolutely amazed by the level,
yes,
of experience, mm-hmm, professionalism,
yes,
and training, mm-hmm, that I could see when I arrived.
Yeah.
Our staff is 95% Cambodian, with a lot of different background.
Yes, yes.
People who have been educated in Australia, in America, in France,
yeah, yeah,
In Europe,
yes,
in Russia, speaking several languages.
Yes, yes.
And having a level of professionalism in our aviation standard.
Yes, yes.
Which is great, mm, and that we need to promote.
I see.
Nevertheless,
yeah,
it's true, it is our duty to transfer expertise,
yes,
to bring training,
mm-hmm,
and that's what we do on our day-to-day life.
Okay.
We have training program, we have skill development,
okay,
for language, for regulation,
yes,
for process, and especially aviation process.
What is aviation process?
As you mentioned, ICAO,
yes, yes,
which are the international regulation,
yes,
everything that we do, and especially in terms of safety and,
yes,
yes, security,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm,
we should be able to train our people,
yes,
that when they make the ground handling,
yes,
when they check in passenger,
okay, okay,
when they embark people,
okay,
they are respecting those processes.
Ah.
So we are applying those regulations,
okay, okay,
and we have to make sure that everybody carry on with,
yeah,
their appropriate training level of certification. And that's why we do this regular training.
So in other words, whatever ICAO is setting as a standard, you know, you are building the capacity of the staff to be able to apply, you know, the level of services to that level.
Yes, yes. We want our people,
yes,
to be at this level of standard.
Yes.
And we want also to attract people,
okay,
who have been trained, who,
yes,
have been educated,
yes,
with this level of standard. We have people who have been working in Los Angeles airport.
Ah, okay.
We have people who have been working in French airport, who have been trained in Europe, who have,
yes,
been trained in Australia.
Yeah, yeah.
So we should be able to propose,
okay,
the environment,
yes,
that,
yes,
these people will stay with us.
Mm.
And I would say that our turnover is very, mm, very low, because,
yeah,
people, I think, are quite happy,
yeah,
working in Cambodia airport, but also to train people,
mm,
if they wish one day they are able to go in international airports,
yes,
big airports,
yes,
outside Cambodia.
Mm. How, just out of curiosity, how many airlines fly to Phnom Penh now?
Today we have 25 airlines,
okay,
flying to Cambodia,
yes,
almost every destination in Asia,
yes,
as you mentioned, Air France to,
yeah, yeah,
to Paris,
yeah,
we are opening new lines,
yes,
new flights, new,
okay,
routes,
okay.
The next one, which already official, is the Philippines, Manila,
oh, okay,
to Siem Reap.
Oh, yes, yes. Oh,
which
good.
Is going to start in April with, mm-hmm, Cebu Pacific.
Yes, yes.
We are also waiting good news from some airlines in Hong Kong.
Yes.
Good news also from our national carrier to fly,
yes,
to Korea.
Yes.
So we see a lot of development.
Mm.
We can see a lot of airlines,
yes,
who are now decided to put Cambodia as their main,
yes, yes,
target, their main objectives,
yes,
to start flight, and,
yes,
it is of course a very good news.
Yeah. Well, per day, how many planes land? You know, you count them. How many? 10, 15, 5?
Oh, much, much more.
Much more. Huh?
Much more. Around 50
You're
airplanes.
Kidding me? Really? Per day? My God. That's a lot of traffic.
It's a lot of traffic.
That's a lot of traffic.
It's a lot of traffic,
yeah,
in Siem Reap,
yes,
in Phnom Penh. I would like to say that, of course, we all benefited from the Chinese New Year and some holidays.
Yes.
Except,
yes,
our staff at the airport.
Yes, yes.
Where we had huge activities.
Yes, yes.
With a lot of flights to, mm, and from China.
Yes.
Actually, we even manage some flights who landed in Phnom Penh and in Siem Reap at 2 in the morning. Wow. We take off from Phnom Penh at 3:30 in the morning.
Wow. That's accommodating.
That's accommodating. Yeah. Carrying yes. A lot of tourists
wow.
from China mm. and to China during the holidays.
Emmanuel, we're coming to the end of the show, and I would like to let my guests have the last word. What's your last word? What do you want the audience to remember from our conversation?
What I would like to say, it's quite simple. We have been here for more than 15 years.
Yes.
We have been investing already a lot of money to
yes.
Develop the airport
yes.
of Cambodia. We are investing for tomorrow. We are investing for the long term.
Yes.
Our vision and the vision that we share internally
yeah.
is moving the world beyond your best airport expectation.
Yeah.
So we are the partner of Cambodia. You are the partner of the government of Cambodia. And of course, our strong motivation is to remain this partner for the very long term.
Yes. Great, Emmanuel. Well, thank you so much for coming on such a short notice. And I just want to wish you all the best, particularly for your future expansion in the country.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
All the best for this year of ASEAN.
Thank you. Well, Excellency, ladies and gentlemen, I'm glad that you could have a glimpse a bit of the air service industry in this country, and particularly we all should be very proud on the development in that particular side. Because in the reconstruction of the country, for those who remember way back in 93, you know, you come to the airport, you know, airport is a gateway. Airport, when people go to a country, that's your first impression of the country, is the welcoming at the airport, is the infrastructure at the airport, is the service at the airport, is basically the image of the country. And I would say that nowadays, when you go to the airport, whether in Phnom Penh or Siem Reap, you feel proud that this is a Cambodian airport. And this is something that in the larger context of the ASEAN member, where in the next 3 years we will be entering a free flow of good and service, people traveling everywhere, it's important that Cambodia capture its rightful place in the region. It's important that Cambodia can benefit from this regionalization. It's important that Cambodia can attract investors. Investors are impressed with what they see when they come. Tourists are impressed with the quality of service when they come and when they leave. So to me, it all boils down to adequate physical infrastructure, you know, if we are to claim our space in the economic region ASEAN. And in this context, I must say that the Cambodia Airport, the Royal Government of Cambodia, the Civil Secretary Civil Aviation Cambodia, they are all working very hard to bring up the quality of service, the standard that we now can enjoy, but that most of us have no clue what are the effort has been gone into. We only see a beautiful airport. We only receive the service, but we don't know that there are so many people behind. There are so much policy behind. There's so much regulation behind. When ICAO is setting a standard to certify our airport, it translates, as Emmanuel was saying, it translates into the airport authority, it translates into the airport company to train the people to be able to understand this rule, to translate it, and then to apply it. And these are the things that we do not see, but we enjoy the service. So on that note, I have to say thank you for Cambodia Airport. Thank you for those who work there, for your 1,300 staff who have made Cambodia Airport proud. So on that note, once again, I hope to see you in a few years from now, and we can talk more about the future of Cambodia. So, good night.
Thank you.
Good night.
Thanks.